Today I will talk about the challenges which are faced by the women seafarer. I picked up the two major challenges. The first one is the problem of non-acceptance. So whenever the lady seafarer joined the vessel, her colleagues are not ready to accept her. Every time she has to prove herself. For this, I want to advise all my lady seafarers that don't worry, be relaxed about it. Only thing, what you need to do is, whenever you do a small job, even a small job, whenever you're doing, do it very perfectly, that your colleague will start developing the trust on you and it will help you in a long way. The second major issue is the problem of loneliness. Of course, whenever there is a one women seafarer amongst the whole crew, this problem will occur. So girls, be mentally prepared for it. Always indulge yourself in some kind of hobby. For the shipping companies, I would like to urge that whenever you are hiring the women on ship, try to send at least two women on board. This will help to eradicate this problem.
I am a deck cadet and have sailed on board ocean-going merchant vessel under Bangladesh Shipping Corporation. I enjoyed the experience in general, but unfortunately, I had to face quite a few incidents such as gender-based attitude, mental harassment, discouragement, etc. Search and rescue is another challenging maritime sector where women participation is very less. I feel that mentoring and supporting is the most important, as well as providing equal training opportunities to increase female participation in search and rescue sector, which is duly identified in the report of International Maritime Rescue Federation. Currently, I am working with International Women Seafarers Foundation to ensure gender neutral and diverse working environment for female seafarers. I believe if proper support from policymakers and gender diverse environment can be ensured, more females will participate in the search and rescue sector.
Women in maritime sector faces lots of challenge. Shipping has been an industry mostly dominated by men, and acceptance for women has not really been very great. Many shipping companies, they don't want to hire women seafarers. Women seafarers many a time suffer because of lapses in the policies. On the work front, they often are undermined by their colleagues, and they need to prove their competencies every single time. For men, their competencies are generally implied by the licenses they possess.
Pay gaps, harassment, mobbing, abuses, unconscious bias, unequal opportunities. I can say more about the challenges of women in maritime, since we still consist a ratio of 2% as women seafarers. We still have maritime companies that they don't employ women on board or closes their ears to the problems of women who have encountered on board or shore-based field jobs. We need to change the perceptions by putting the positive impact of women when they are employed at a company, but we need to change the behaviors to the women as first. So speaking up is important. Making the voices and problems more visible will create that sustainable environment for all seafarers. We will make it together, with all men and women in maritime together, because we are diverse, we are equal, we are stronger together. This is the only one way to create that sustainable shipping future.